So, first things first, it's official. Trinity 5-2, formerly known as Naomi, is in Impact Wrestling, and it looks like she's going after the world championship and the world champion in Deonna Purrazzo. However, in a recent interview, Trinity opened up about her WWE departure, saying that the way that she was talked to and handled contributed to some of the reasons as to why she departed from WWE. She went on to talk about how her time in WWE felt like the lowest part of her wrestling career. So I wanted to know, first and foremost, how do you feel about Trinity's debut, her immediate inclusion into the main event picture, and some of her comments that she had to say about her WWE departure?
Shout out to my dad's vocals that are picking up in the background. Regards to Trinity, I honestly love the way that she conducted herself, because she kind of just addressed the elephant in the room, but she went about it in a classy way without so much dragging them, and pretty much putting it out there saying that, yeah, I left on my own terms. You see, the thing about Trinity that, like, I feel so strongly about is how people... Lovely. How disgusting. I picked it up. Anyways, going back to what I was saying with Trinity, the thing that I've been seeing for like the last couple of weeks that's been making me very upset is people acting like Trinity doesn't have like a brain cell of her own, that she only left due to Mercedes, and that, you know, she did want to do it as a joint thing, just go wherever she goes and ride off of, you know, her charisma, her high, her power that she has. And I like the fact that she just kind of like just stomped out everything. Where everyone was just saying that, yeah, she just did it for her. You know, she just straight up said, yeah, I didn't like my own treatment. I don't like the way I was being presented the last couple of years. And that, you know, me coming to Impact was a very much a me choice, not because it was a last option, not because I'm desperate, right, but because I want to be here, you know? And I love that. I love the way that she presented herself. I like the way Impact actually presented her and put her right away in the title picture, because although a lot of people don't like that, you know, because she's an outsider coming the inside, but I think, as Jordan put it last week, this is very much needed for Impact. She is the star power going into Impact, and she knows that. And I feel like she takes herself seriously. So although I did shade Impact last week, and I know I shaded it, Jordan pretty much enlightened me, if you will, on the benefits of her going over there. Not that she needs the uplifting, but Impact itself needs the facelift. Not that the women's division sucks, but the brand itself is kind of musty. I'm not going to hold you. But her going over there is going to give it the facelift that it needs. So I like what she's doing, because what Sasha's doing over there in Stardom, bring attention to Stardom, Trinity's doing that over there, you know? And she's going somewhere where, more, most importantly above all, she is feeling like she's appreciated and she's going to be taken seriously. Because I don't think she was taken seriously for the last decade of her career. She won the SmackDown Women's Championship once. And then the tag team championship, not the Divas championship. She didn't win a Royal Rumble, even though that's literally her specialty. I hope that, honestly, she is happy where she's at, and I can't wait to see what she does in Impact. But what did you think about her response and how she was presented in Impact?
So for starters, I think, like you said, her response was perfect. It was spot on. I love how she addressed kind of the elephant in the room, the biggest issue in the room, as it pertained to her treatment with WWE. And I'm noticing a trend, right? You know, Mercedes didn't like the way that she was treated. I guess Naomi didn't like the way that she was treated. And so I think from there, like you said, you have to go where you are appreciated, where you are wanted, where you are desired. And I think that that's what she's doing with Impact Wrestling. I feel like they want her there. And because they want her there, she is going to make an immediate impact, because they're going to do what's necessary to highlight her as the star that she is. And I'm very, very happy about that. I'm very, very happy that she's going to be in an environment where I know that she can thrive. Speaking of environment where I know that she can thrive, shout outs to Mercedes for popping out and supporting her girl. That brought a smile. Flying from Japan to support your best friend. That's a real best friend. Cool. So seeing, you know, Mercedes pop out, show support, I think that that was just a beautiful thing to see. And like you said, what Mercedes is doing in New Japan is what Trinity is doing in Impact Wrestling. She is bringing in immense amount of star power, because I feel like it's interesting, kind of what I'm trying to find a good comparison. to it. But I don't want to like compare what Trinity is doing to anything in the past, because I feel like it would be too dramatic and taken out of context. But what I will say is that the women's division in Impact is strong. Like, it's one of those things that it's like a basketball team that just needs a star player. Like, they have their role players, they have their vets, but they don't have a star. And I feel like Trinity is that star. They have great in-ring technicians. They have high flyers. They have powerful women. They have legends. But Trinity, I believe, is going to be filling that star role. Actually, very similar to how Kurt Angle was when he came into Impact Wrestling in 2006, when, you know, Impact was kind of like at its peak, right? They had Samoa Joe and AJ Styles, and they had all these great wrestlers, and they had this great mix of talent, but they just didn't have the notable face that can draw attention to the product. So I think that what Trinity is actually doing in Impact is similar to kind of what Kurt was doing to Impact when he went and joined TNA years ago. So
I love that you brought that up, because I saw on Twitter that a lot of people made that comparison, but some of the Black community was not saying, they were not jacking that. They were saying that it's not the same thing. You know, they were saying that it's different because, I mean, Kurt Angle, he was pretty much held to a high regard throughout his whole WWE run. Even if, like, he wasn't in the title picture, he was still taken pretty, like, seriously, like, in terms of, like, maybe his matches, even though he was a goofy character or a serious character. Whereas with Trent, she, like, was rarely properly represented, or every time, like, she was getting some momentum, they kind of stomped off whatever storyline she had going and didn't really allow that much development with her character or give her the amount of title runs or pay-per-view focused segments or matches. So I'm happy that you kind of brought that up. Because you're on the opposite.
I think it was on Twitter where I saw it, as far as, like, the that comparison. I thought that was actually perfect, but I was like, should I say it? I don't know. But
no, I love that you addressed it. That's actually interesting. We're on different ends with that.
Exacto mundo. But anyway, we're gonna move on. But before we move on, just want to let y'all know, like, if y'all have any comments about Trinity being in Impact Wrestling, let us know in the comments below how you feel about this. I'm very, very excited and happy for her, but we're gonna move on. So speaking of wrestling outside